Hello friends, today I am going to discuss conflict and view serializability. Before going to start the video, I request all of you that kindly share and subscribe. I describe what do you mean by conflict serializability. If a schedule AS can be transformed into a schedule S dash by a series of swaps of non-conflict instructions which say that AS and S dash are conflict equivalent. Here, non-conflicting instruction means, suppose there are two transactions T1 and T2, they read the data item A and B. Since they read the distinct data items, for this reason, this transaction is called non-conflicting. If they read the same data item, then that transaction is conflict instructions. We say that a schedule AS is conflict serializable if it is conflict equivalent to a serial schedule. By swapping non-conflict instructions, we can create conflict serializable instructions. Here are some examples of schedules that is not conflict serializable. Suppose there is two transactions T3 and T4, but they read the same data item. For these reasons, we cannot swap the instructions. We are unable to swap instructions in the above schedule to obtain either the serial schedule T3 or T4 or the serial schedule T4 and T3. I describe it with an example. Suppose transaction T1 and T2, they read the data item A and B. In these transactions, T1 read A, then update the value of A, then T2 read A, update the value of A, then again T1 read B, then write B, then again T2 read B, and write B. Here read write operations on data item A and read operations on data item A and T2, they are non-conflicting. So we can swap this value and it produce the schedules that is a non-conflict instructions. View serializable. By swap these instructions, we create a view serializable in schedule 1 and schedule 2. Read operations in transition T1 and T2 are same. Write operations also same. Here, content of the two schedules are same, but order of executions are different. For the reasons, it is called view serializable. The let AS and S dash be two schedules with the same set of instructions. AS and S dash are view equivalent if the following three conditions are met. For F1, for each data item Q, if transaction TI read the initial value of Q in schedule S, then transaction TI must in schedule S dash also read the initial value of Q. For each data item Q, transaction TI executes the read Q in schedule S, that value was produced by transaction TJ, then transaction TI must in schedule S dash also read the value of Q that was produced by transaction TJ. Rule 3, for each data item Q, the transactions that performs the final write operations in schedule S must perform the final write operation in schedule S dash. As you can see, view equivalent is also based purely on read and write alone. That means here read operations and write operations are same in schedule S too, but the order are different. Now I describe the view serializable. A schedule S is view serializable if it is view equivalent to serial schedule. Every conflict serializable schedule is also view serializable. Here is a transaction. Suppose read Q, transaction T3 perform read Q and write Q. T4 depends on T3 that perform write Q. T6 depends on write Q. So here three transactions perform the write operations without terminating of the final operations. For the reasons, it is also called blind writes. Recurability. Suppose transaction T8 and T9. Transition T8 read and write the value of A, which will be read by transition T9. But at the point of transition T8, a failure occurs, then it cannot be recovered since T8, T9 commit immediately after the read A operations. So, first of all, that read B operation first finish, then read A operations perform, then it is recovered possible. Otherwise, it is not recovered possible. Need to address the effect of transaction failure on concurrently running transaction recover schedules. If a transaction TJ reads a data item previously written by transaction TI, the commit operation TI appear before the commit operation TJ. That is, after T8 finished, then T9 performs read operations. Otherwise, it cannot be recoverable. Here, the schedule 3 is not recoverable if T9 commits immediately after the read. If T8 should abort, T9 would have read and possibly shown by to the user. An inconsistent database state. Hence, database must ensure schedules are recoverable. Recoverability. There is another example, that is cascading rollback. Suppose T10 perform the read operations on data item A and B, and also perform the write operation data item A. T11 access the data item A, which will be updated by transaction T10, and T12 reach the data item A, which will be also updated by transaction 11. But at this point, write operations of transaction 10, if failure has occurred, then T10 is rollback. T11 depends on T10, since it is also rollback, and T12 depends on T10, then it is also rollback. Therefore, one transaction failures, there is a series of transactions rollback. Such type rollback is called cascading rollback. A single transaction failure leads to a series of transaction rollback. Okay, if T10 fails, then T11, T12 must also be rolled back. Recoverability. Cascading schedules rollback occurs for each pair of transactions TI and TJ, such that TJ reads a data item previously written by TI, the commit operation TI appears before the read operation TJ. Every cascadeless schedule is also recoverable. It is desirable to restrict the schedules to those that are cascadeless. We are testing the serializability by using the precedence graph. Here both transactions, here transactions are specified by the BATIF and are defined the read and write operation between two transactions. A graph, a directed graph for the vertices of the transactions, and we draw an arc from TI to TJ if two transactions conflict. That is, there is at least one write operation, so it is called conflict. And TI access the data item on which the conflict occurs LDR. There are some examples. Conflict serializable in DBMS. A schedule is also called conflict serializable if it can be transformed into a serial schedules by swapping of non-conflicting instructions that I described earlier. Two operations are said to be conflicting if all of conditions satisfied. They belong to different transactions. They operate on the same data item. At least one of the operations is write operations. Suppose conflict operations pair R1A. R1A means transaction T1 perform the read operations, and W2A means transaction T2 perform write operations. These are conflict instructions because they access the same data item. There is another example. Suppose transaction T1 perform the write operations and transaction T2 perform the write operations. These are conflicts since they are performed write operations on the same data item. Similarly, these operations are conflicting. But there is a non-conflicting operation. Suppose transaction T1 performed the read operation on data item A and transaction T2 performed the write operations on data item B. Since A and B are distinct values, so this is a non-conflicting instruction. Similarly, W1A and W2B. Here is an example of non-conflicting instructions. Here, transaction T1 performed the read operations, T1 perform write operations on data item A, T2 performs read operation on data item A, T2 perform write operation on data item A. And again, there is a transaction T2. Transaction T1 perform read instructions B, transaction T1 perform write instruction on data item B, transaction T2 perform read operation on data item B, transaction perform write operation on data item B. We separate the both transactions. Here read 1, write 1, read 1, write 1. Again read 2, write 2, read 2, write 2. There are two transactions. Possible serial schedules are T1 to T2 or T2 to T1. These are non-conflicting instructions. There is another example. Here read instructions of A. Transition T1 perform read instructions. Transition T1 perform write operations. Transition T1 perform read instruction data item B. Again, transition T1 perform write instruction data item B. And transition T2 perform read instruction data item A, function T2 perform write instructions on data item A. Similarly, these two operations, we swapping both operations, we swap the instruction by defining their colors, and we write this instruction in following manner. We describe it using the precedence graph. Suppose there are three transactions T1, T2, T3, and transaction T1 perform read instruction, write instructions in this way. Suppose transaction T1 perform read instructions and T2 perform write instructions. So there is a precedence graph from T1 to T2. Again, T2 performs read instructions on data item Z, and T3 perform write instruction data item Z. So there is a link between T2 to T3. Again, transaction T3 perform write instruction data item Y, and transaction T1 perform read instruction data item Y. So there is a link between T3 to T1. We can see that the precedence graph, but here we see that there is a circle. The circle shows that the circle shows here that schedule is not conflict serializable. So circle is a necessary condition that schedule is not conflict serializable. If there is no circle, then schedule is conflict serializable. Here is another example. Transaction T3 perform read instructions and transaction T1 perform write operations. So there is a direct link between T3 to T1. Again, transaction T1 perform read instructions and transaction T2 perform write instructions. So there is a link between T1 to T2. Again, transaction T3 perform read Z instructions and transaction T2 perform read Z instruction. Here is a write Z instruction, here is a read Z instruction. So there is a link between T3 to T2. Here we get the precedence graph, which is not circle. So it is called not conflict serializable. And there is a possible serials link T3 to T1, arrangement T2. Thank you very much.